The proficiency we're working on today is actually one of the, it isn't a content standard, it's one of the learning expectations, so a transferable skill. And that one is a habit of learning, which is called precision. So how that's manifesting today is students are getting instructions for a design project that's using compass and straight edge. And we have just recently been learning a little bit about using those tools by going through a whole set of exercises to develop skillfulness in them. And now they're kind of putting them all together and creating a pentagon and a decagon design. So what I really try to do is one of the general math practices is called productive struggle, and trusting that students can struggle and they can work through that, and to provide them with chances to struggle. And so it, rather than my being up front just teaching them and everybody together, we're all doing this together, it's like, okay, here are the instructions, here's what you need to turn in, it's all written down. Can you follow precisely a set of procedures and construct something and then construct another thing and then design a project? So every element of that project will be assessed on the same rubric about precision.
Like when I look here, this is just a little, that arc looks a little longer than that one to me.
Oh, so we just find a bunch of, we find all these middles?
Yeah.
That's really exciting.
Isn't it? I love the way that works.
Oh my goodness, I know how to do this.
Well, you follow these new steps. It's another way to do it. Follow these steps. You really precisely followed those steps, so I think you can do it well there. Let me get you some paper.
Nobody was off task. They were all working hard. Some of them would get frustrated because maybe they had to try a design, three, four times before it looked right, because there's human error when you use tools, and it's a good thing to learn about.
Right, but this is the construction you're trying to do. You're trying to make a perpendicular through point A. Do you remember how we did that?
You extend it, and then it says so on both sides.
Yeah.
Here, and then I go.
Yeah, you get a segment, and then you bisect that segment.
They would ask me for their feedback, and I would say, it doesn't really look so precise to me. This doesn't really look like a pentagon with five equal sides. So, should I do it again? They might ask, and I'd say, well, I think if you want to get a 4, on proficiency or on this proficiency, which is precision, doesn't look that precise to me. It looks okay.
Okay, so it looks like you have pretty much finished your project. So on the back, if you remember, we looked at the beginning of class at the rubric to grade your precision. So that's the LE you're looking at. If you combined all the three designs as well as your final project, what do you think you deserve, 1, 2, 3, or 4? And then here, explain why.
Okay.
Well, I think it's important for students to reflect and not to have it all coming from the teacher, but for them to sit back and say, I really did really well on this. I was very precise. So I like to have students self-assess on these projects, and then I will also assess. But I want them to just let me know what do they think they deserve and why. And so I just want to give them an opportunity to give their input of how well they felt like they met that proficiency. I think that there is this danger of ignoring best practices in instruction. And I think that's where we're finally kind of coming around to talking about actual instruction in some of our PLC groups. So I think that you got to be careful not to sort of say it's the assessing and it's the setting of the goals and all of that makes good education. You've also got to talk about how do you instruct someone to write well? What are the best strategies? And so I guess I would say, don't think that I'm going to go here and all questions will be answered. You still have to keep in mind, how do you actually instruct?